Now we have seen how the secant method works. The way the secant method works is very similar to regular falsi, except the difference between the secant and the regular falsi is that every time we get x of I plus 1, we replace the oldest solution and not necessarily bothered whether the solution the guesses are going to bracket the true solution or not. So this was what we did in Microsoft Excel in the previous lecture when we worked with regular falsi. What I am going to do again is just copy the previous lecture, essentially just create a copy of the previous lecture so that I do not have to redo everything, and we will call this as the secant method. Okay. In the secant method, what we are interested is again solving the same problem 2 minus x plus ln of x using the secant method. Okay. And in the secant method, we do not have the concept of xl and xr, instead we have x of I plus 1 and x of I minus 1 and x of I. So x, this guy is going to be nothing but x of I minus 1. The next guy is going to be nothing but x of I. Likewise, we will have f of I minus 1 and we will have f of I. Okay. So these are the two solutions, the two guesses of the solution that we are going to start off with, and then compute x of I plus 1, f of x of I plus 1. And the product fl multiplied by f of I plus 1 is not needed at all. So we will just delete that part. Okay. And let's go ahead and delete this part also completely, so that we start with almost a blank slate. We will start with the initial conditions that we started off with. So we start off with the two initial solutions, x of 0 is equal to 1 and x of 1 is equal to 4. We calculate f of 0. F of 0, again same way as we had calculated in the previous lecture of this module, 2 minus b4 minus, sorry, plus ln of b4. And likewise for f of I is going to be 2 minus c4 plus ln of c4. X of I plus 1, as we had said, was computed using x of I minus 1 minus f of I minus 1 multiplied by x I minus 1 divided by f I minus 1. Okay. So this is that particular slope term, this is the f term, and this is the x term at I minus 1. Okay. And it is exactly the same as we have done in the regular falsi method, the computing of x I plus 1 given x I minus 1 and x I. So we have not bothered rewriting that particular formula. Remember, we had just copied that particular formula from our previous case. So again, we do not need f of I plus 1 and the error at the product f of I plus 1 multiplied by f of I at this stage. We will just move the error over here. So this is all that we need for the secant method. In iteration 2, when the iteration number, when I is equal to 2, x I minus 1 is nothing but x of 2 minus 1, which is x of 1. And if you notice, x of 1 at the previous iteration was this particular value. So we will do equal to this guy. So that is what our x of I minus 1 is going to be when I equal to 2. X of I when I equal to 2 is the x of I plus 1 when I equal to 1, right? Because when I was equal to 1, x of I plus 1 is nothing but x2. When I equal to 2, x of I is nothing but x2. So we will write this as equal to x of I plus 1. Okay. And now what we do to compute f of I minus 1, we just drag this over here. To compute f of I, we just drag this over here. And to compute x of I plus 1, we just drag this. And the same way with respect to the error, we are going to drag. Okay. And now we select this entire row and drag it again, maybe for a total of 10 iterations, let us see. And yes, so that is the 10 iterations. So that is what we have we now have gotten, and we see that it has converged essentially in 6 iterations. So we will go ahead and delete this part. Okay. So our error criterion was that the error should fall below the epsilon value was 1e-4. Here the error is 3.7e-4, as a result of which we repeat this for one more iteration and we get 4e-4, and the solution that we get over here is essentially 3.14619. That is going to be the solution using the secant method. Okay. So now if you compare, what I want to do is I just want to compare the results of the regular falsi method with the results of the secant method. So what I will do is I will just copy what we had done with regular falsi method in our previous lecture and just paste it over here just for comparison. I will click on paste special, we only want the values, we do not want the computation. So, we will just paste the values over here. Okay. So, what we started off what happened in the regular falsi method is that at all times the new guesses of the solution that we generated were all generated to the left of the true solution x star. As a result of this, x r, that is the right hand solution, remained the same at 4.0 all the time. And it was only this solution that we kept changing with the number of iterations. But if you see what is happening in the secant method, the first solution was dropped, second solution was moved back, and the new solution came over here. In the third iteration, it was the second solution was dropped, third iteration moved here, and the new solution moved over here. In the fourth iteration, the third solution was dropped, the previous solution was moved here, and the new solution came over here, so on and so forth. So what we did in the secant method is to retain only the last two solutions, not the left and right solution, and that is essentially where the secant method differs from the regular falsi method. In regular falsi method, we essentially kept the solution such that they bracket both the solutions at any given time. Okay. So, that is essentially the way the secant method works.